my friend are in an intimate relationship with something called the internet. In fact, the internet is your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your husband, your wife, your partner. And of course, I know you might be thinking I'm crazy for saying this, or that there's no way you're in an intimate relationship with your partner on the internet, but you are. Because think about it, right? You spend hours with each other every single day. You go to breakfast, to lunch, to dinner with each other all the time. You go to bed with each other every night and look at each other just before you turn the lights out. And when you wake up in the morning, who's the first person you look at? Your partner, the internet. And when you feel sad, the first person you reach out to is the internet. And when you feel good or you've got something great to say or some news to share, the internet, your partner, is always the first one to hear it. So, you may tell yourself you're not in a relationship with the internet, but you are. And I'm here to let you know, as your friend, I think it's time to have a breakup. I think it's time you need to go your separate ways because this person is just not good for you. Let me give you a bunch of reasons why your partner, the internet, is just not a good partner for you. Okay, number one, your partner, your intimate partner, the internet, is a liar. In fact, they are lying to you all the time. They'll tell you things like global warming isn't actually happening, or that the Kardashians are actually interesting people, or there's a skin cream out there that if you put it on your face, it'll make you look younger. Oh God, your partner's a goddamn liar. Number two, your partner has an obsessive compulsive disorder over numbers, and specifically numbers and lists. Every time you get together, all they want to do is talk about the top 10 countries that you'll never have enough money to actually travel to, or the 6 foods that you need to eat every single day in order to be healthy, even though your local grocery store doesn't sell those foods, and the 5 things that you can do to decrease the stress that comes along with knowing that your life is shit. Number three, your partner has a lot of friends who brag about a lot of really weird things. Some of them brag about the fact that they have a lot of followers or stalkers, even though they stalk the same people who stalk them. Some of them brag about the fact that they just recently secured a relationship with a ring, even though those types of relationships statistically fail over 50% of the time. Yay! Some of them even brag about the fact that they just got this brand new job, even though they're gonna hate that job in the months to come. Your partner's friends are weird. Number four, your partner is fabricating stories all of the time. I mean, the other night you guys were out for dinner and your partner started telling you some story about a politician doing something that that politician didn't actually do. And you got all upset about it, you started getting angry about it, and you started yelling and screaming, and then your partner jumped in and said, no, I was just joking, I was just kidding, you know what, that didn't actually really happen. It was just a bit of fake news I was throwing your way. And you started calming down and laughing yourself. You're like, my partner has such a crazy imagination sometimes. Number five. Your partner has an exceptional number of resources to help you commit a crime and get away with it, or to buy a handgun, or to make a homemade bomb. I think your partner might be a terrorist. Do not post that on Facebook. Number six, your partner does not know what God it believes in. One day it's Jesus Christ, the next day it's Allah, and the next day they're telling you they're an atheist. I'm here to let you know, I think your partner might have a multiple personality disorder. Number seven, your partner has an unhealthy addiction to cats and dogs and babies. I mean, was that one of your non-negotiables when you were looking for the perfect relationship? Number eight, your partner spends almost all of their time with people who are looking for sex. In fact, someone is using your partner for sex right now, this very second. In fact, hold on, wait for it. Yes, that's right. Somebody in the world just became pregnant because of your partner. Your partner's cheating on you. Number nine, whenever you ask your partner a question, they give you the answer in like 0.83 seconds. No thought, no care. Here's the answer I think you should have. I'm off to the next thing. You're dating Rain Man. Number 10, last but not least, your partner has a serious ADHD problem. I mean, one second you're having a really nice conversation about recipes for shortbread, and your partner comes in and says, hey, by the way, do you know that at Christmas time, lots of people eat shortbread? And did you know that Christmas is only 141 days away? And you're like, no, I didn't know that. Should I be thinking about that? And your partner's like, yeah, if you want to get the best electronic gadgets for your friends for Christmas, you do. And you're like, oh, electronic gadgets, are there new ones coming out? And your partner's like, duh, yeah, new electronic gadgets are coming out of China every single day. Did you not know that? And by the way, did you know that China is one of the greatest places to travel to? And you're like, no, I didn't even really know that. I've never thought about traveling there. And your partner's like, well, if you really want to live, you have to travel to China. Here are some amazing pictures. And you're like, oh wow, those are really awesome. And while you're looking at those pictures, your partner says, by the way, did you know that shortbread causes cancer? So, my friend, it is time to break up with this partner. This partner is not good for you, and it's never gonna lead you to the things that you really want from life. And if you're gonna do it, make it a good breakup. You know, the kind of breakup where you can still go back and see each other from time to time, have lunch, you know, a glass of wine, a little rebound sex, you know, those kinds of things that we all need in life. But from there, you cannot spend as much time with this person as you do. Because if you do, this relationship is going to kill you. Thanks for checking out that video, my friend. I've got one more over here for you. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And next to that, you can also subscribe to my weekly newsletter. If you do, you get a free gift. How cool is that? And last but not least, please make sure that you share this with other people. Together, we can change the world. All right, thanks. Bye-bye.